Welcome to ATCM, the Emergency Medicine Channel. Today we are discussing about a syndrome which you all know, that is Bratz syndrome. Bratz syndrome is very simple syndrome, but it is very complicated in a clinical practice, in your clinical practice. Whenever you have renal failure, whether it is acute renal failure or chronic renal failure, potassium will not be removed from the body. There will be accumulation of potassium in your body because kidneys are normally removing potassium from our body. So potassium is elevated, that is called as hyperkalemia. One of the major complications of hyperkalemia is bradycardia and hypotension. Most of the patients who is having renal failure may have diabetes also, because diabetes is one of the common condition where you get chronic renal failure. So they can have renal failure. Most of these diabetic patients can have heart disease, coronary artery disease. Doctors usually start beta blocker for coronary artery disease. So patients are on beta blockers. The problem with beta blockers are many beta blockers are long acting drugs, except metoprolol, that has got only 6-hour action, but all other beta blockers are either 12 hours or 24 hour action. So their excretion is mainly through kidneys. So when there is renal failure, the cumulative effect of the beta blocker can also be there. So that also produces bradycardia. So hyperkalemia and beta blockers in a patient with renal failure can produce severe bradycardia and hypotension. This is called as Bratz syndrome. We'll see what are the components of Bratz syndrome. There is bradycardia, severe bradycardia, which may not respond to your routine treatment. Renal failure, we have already explained. AV node blockers like beta blockers, verapamil, diltiazem, and patient will go to shock. Hyperkalemia, that is Bratz syndrome. B stands for bradycardia, R stands for renal failure, A stands for AV node blocker, S stands for shock, H stands for hyperkalemia. Now this syndrome, characters of this syndrome we have already explained. Beta blockers, which are long acting drugs which is not removed from the body, with hyperkalemia because of renal failure, patient can have severe bradycardia and hypotension and hyperperfusion. That is Bratz syndrome. You can see this slide. It's a cycle of this cycle shows there is a problem in the SA node. Both beta blockers and potassium blocks the SA node and reduces the rate of the heart. You get bradycardia. So patient is having hyperkalemia and AV node blocker in a patient who is having renal failure. So potassium is not removed, beta blockers are not removed. Cumulative effect of this is going to produce severe bradycardia and hypotension. Normally when you have hyperkalemia, it will be indicated through an ECG. When you take ECG, you get very tall T waves, universal tall T waves, bradycardia, and QRS complex widening, sine wave pattern, and cardiac arrest. So bradycardia is one of the common presentation of hyperkalemia, and it is one of the common complication of beta blocker. Together, this hyperkalemia and beta blockers produces severe bradycardia which may not respond to your routine treatment. So the ECG shows severe bradycardia. The drug of choice in Bratz syndrome is like any other hyperkalemia. You have to treat the hyperkalemia. You have to give calcium gluconate. You have to give insulin dextrose infusion. You have to give potassium binding resins to reduce the potassium absorption. All these things will be helpful in a case of simple hyperkalemia because of renal failure. But patient is having bradycardia because of cumulative effect of beta blocker plus hyperkalemia. So you require something else to treat this. Adrenal is one of the important drug which can be used in this situation. So you treat hyperkalemia as a routine treatment in emergency room. You give calcium gluconate, you give salbutamol nebulization, you give Lasix, all these things. Along with this primary treatment, you have to give adrenaline as an infusion. That is a treatment of choice. The dose of adrenaline or epinephrine in this Bratz syndrome is recommended dose is 0 to 10 microgram per minute as an infusion. Okay, so that infusion can slowly improve the heart rate and pumping of the heart. Other treatment protocols for giving hyperkalemia should also be given. So we have explained in detail about Bratz syndrome. This is a very common problem, but we don't know exactly what is happening in this situation. We might have faced this problem in many of our patients, but remember, both beta blockers with hyperkalemia together in a case of severe renal failure will produce severe bradycardia hypotension. Along with the treatment of hyperkalemia, you can give adrenaline to counter the adverse effects of this syndrome. Thank you.